Hello everyone, and welcome to season one of Eventing in 2024. You are watching the first event vlog of the year. Of course it has to be a Sydney vlog, so tomorrow we are on our way to SIAC. Hopefully we can create a carbon copy of the last event and the one before that, where, you know, we won. I'm going in with no expectations though. My only goal is to just have a nice, positive, clear cross-country round, because next weekend we're doing the one star. So there's a lot going on right now. I am like so excited. We just got to stay cool, calm and collected. Going up on dressage day, which is tomorrow, same as last time. We're just going to drive up, tack up, go straight into dressage because that worked well. It's Friday, 7:30 right now, and I just had to start the video because the lighting is so pretty. I'm with my girl Diana now, and I just have to finish packing, and then I'm going to meet Ruby at the paddocks at 6 a.m. tomorrow morning. And we'll get on our way for a 10:54 dressage test. This is like the last thing I need to pack. I already put my bridle numbers on and my lucky brow band on. It's getting dark, but I have everything in my tack box, my stuff up there. The car is packed. This is how excited I am. We have breakfast for tomorrow, overnight oats. Lunch tomorrow morning, 5 a.m. I'm making sandwiches with my pre-cut veggies. My sandwich station, and dinner, I have a pasta salad for me, Ruby, and Amy. I'm gonna put this stuff in the fridge and then I'm gonna go to bed. Good night. I'm trying to prove to Ruby that I do in fact have the potential to be early to things.
Hello! Brianna was on time.
Yay!
I was late by 1 minute, so I feel like I've like let myself down a little bit.
Yeah, super groom title has been revoked. Just kidding.
The sky's really nice, and what we've been traveling for like 30 minutes.
Yeah. Time flies
when you're having fun. This is take two of the sky.
We'll do many takes.
Many takes.
Can you see the windmills?
There we go. So pretty.
Oh no, you saw a truck. Okay. There you go.
Some people are good at trivia, guessing music, pop songs. I'm good at guessing Brianna's entire life story.
Yeah.
So
Ruby knows me better than anyone, I would say. So instead of me recapping all the past times I've been to Sydney, I'll let Ruby go in order.
Do you want me to give first details time, about what happened to each bed?
If you want to.
So first time was May 2022. Finn fell off the float. She had an anxiety attack. There was a mark on his bum. She was really worried about the dressage test. She was sitting in third after the dressage test.
Oh my god, this is insane.
She went on cross country. She had one stop. And then she was really pissed off with herself because she forgot the show jumping course. I could also tell you all the songs that we used.
Oh my god.
May was,
Because you're here with me now, I don't want you to go.
Boom, boom, Flume, with like, say it. That one, you had like a very mid dressage test. This is
very, very mid.
This is like her words. Finny was a bit uncontent. But then you had three stops on cross country.
Yeah.
Yeah. But you were like ecstatic, bawling your eyes out because you actually got around. Goal, and you had a clear show jumping around in your dingy little brown saddle that we all hated. And that was fabulous.
This is too much detail.
That we came last, and and we were so happy. Yeah. All of us were actually like genuinely thrilled. Just so you're up to it, we were the third time we went to Sydney. This was your first clear 95. You had like a dressage test that you were like thrilled with. It was great. And then one rail and show jumping, and
I don't even remember.
I just got such a good memory.
Then
cleared cross country, which is just like the highlight of life. September we came back. That was great because Brie actually won. And
she actually
pulled something off there. So as you could expect, that was double clear cross country, clear show jumping, dressage,
best,
great.
Best weekend ever.
Bim bom boom. No, it wasn't. Then we came back in November. Oh, we came back in October for Equimillion. That was just...
Oh my god, you even remember that?
You came in October, but that doesn't really count because that was just grooming.
Six,
right? Was November, where you won by 10 points and got like the highest ruggy thing. So that was also good. Yeah, so now we've come back to SIAC for the seventh time.
This is Ruby's first time coming to Sydney.
Yeah. So we're keen and
very, very excited.
Yeah, it should be good. You got it on you. Hello, Amy.
Hello, Finny Bear.
Why is it doing so smiling?
Hello, everybody. We've just finished plaiting up, and now I'm going to do his tail. I think people are like interested in the event prep, so I'll show you how I put it in. But first, I plait up the top, starting really high and just taking tiny, tiny little bits of hair. This is not my best work.
It's a going all right.
I have to let go of little bits underneath so that it doesn't get too thick. Okay, so I start a little plait here at the base of his tail, and then I thread the false tail through like that, and then I just continue plaiting so that it's secure. And I might thread it through a second time as well. Oh god.
Okay.
Like that. And you just want to keep the plait nice and tight.
Oh. And there we go.
Brianna is running a little bit late for dressage.
She's left us behind.
She's just trotted off, which is really mean.
And it's cooking.
It's very hot. I think it's like 29.
Someone said to me in the warm-up that we should have got extra points for those quarter marks, which makes me so happy. Anyway, I assumed that the arenas up the very top here were for the big classes, so that's my fault for not checking. But yeah, we were a bit rushed getting from the warm-up down the bottom up to these main arenas up here, but Finny was on the job, his head was in the game, and our centre line was nice and straight, but you can probably see there he was sort of swinging his head, being a bit weird about the bridle there, and the comment on the centre line says some tilting of head, and yeah, they said tilting a couple of times in the comments. I first noticed that he was doing it probably the ride before this event, and then it was definitely noticeable in this test, unfortunately. And I realized he's actually due to get his teeth done. So I booked that in for when we got home. Our lovely dentist, shout out to Lara from LP Equine Dental. She said he was definitely due, but there was nothing necessarily wrong, just some minor work that needed to be done, but nothing out of the ordinary, which was great to hear. And I'm very grateful that he's a good communicator, and he's said to me, hey, I'm a little bit sore, and yeah, we got that fixed up and he's all good now. I don't know where we're up to. I wasn't actually watching the test for any of that first minute, but I remember the first canter transition was a bit late and the comment said that I needed to prepare more and he's not on my aids, and I was like, yep, fair enough. And then yeah, he was being a bit funny in the bridle in front of the judge there, which was annoying. I thought it was a nice accurate transition on X there though. He was very, very good considering he must have been a bit sore in the mouth. Nothing serious, like I said, I'm not neglecting my horse or anything. I only noticed the ride before this, but it just meant that it wasn't our best test, unfortunately. And I was sort of compensating with my hands a bit, I'd say. So they're more uneven than usual.
Better, much better. Good boy.
Yeah, that canter transition was much more fluent. But the comment for our circle here says tilting. So it's definitely noticeable in the canter and the trot. Actually, that looks okay.
Second circle's looking a bit better. Go Finn.
Exactly. He goes better on the right rein.
And we've got Sammy on for the first time today in the eventing world, guys. Get keen.
She means my beautiful new Sam Shield helmet, if you're not sure.
Good boy. Fabulous.
And yeah, that transition was pretty much smack on C, but wasn't very fluid, but still scored well.
Some length and trot?
Yes, our terrible length and trot. Well, it actually scores okay in the eventing world, but...
And Finney looks like he's holding his own against these incredibly fancy horses in the warm-up. Pretty good transition.
It was all right. The comment says we need to maintain the flow, which is fair. And if you've watched my other vlogs, you'll know how excited I was to have had no jig jogging for almost a year. May 2023 was the last time he broke in the walk during a test. So you'll know how gutted I was to have had him break in this test, because it would have been pretty close to perfect in my books. Apart from the head tilting for the third time in a row at this very, very special venue of ours. And it was a really bad break too.
Ooh.
Yeah, he felt like he was going to jig jog again in the corner there, but it was very out of character for him. But
recovered nicely.
Held it together for a nice transition at sea there. And then, yeah, we did our little half circle and came down the centre line, and I was not very happy. I was just like beating myself up.
And oh, we're done. Sorry guys, should have let my test.
I think I just relaxed too much because old habits die hard. So we'll have to watch that from now on.
Well done, Finny!
It was still a very nice test, other than the head tilting and the jig jog, to sit us in fifth.
Nice recovery.
It is hot.
I met this really feral rat on the side of the road.
Hair, Charlie screwed it up.
That was she was already screwed up beforehand.
You look so stunning. Okay, I've got the Sammy on. The horse is here. The rat's here. We're walking back from dressage. There's too many people. I'm scared.
embarrassed.
We're walking back from dressage. I've been tasked with looking after this horse for like the next hour, because that's how long little slow Brianna's going to take to walk across country. And Liv's doing her first one, so I'll get keen. Okay, Finn, we'll see you later. So bye, Finn. It's 11:11, make a wish. So I'm walking from dressage straight to the cross country course because they're kind of close by. Ruby's kindly taking Finn back to the float. I don't have hat, I don't have sunscreen, and I've barely made it 200 meters and I have to stop and take off my boots because they hurt. There's no way I'm getting around a whole course. I'm literally gonna walk it in my socks.
Well,
dressage time was quite close to my cross country time, 12:55, so that's why I thought I'd better just walk it straight away, get it over and done with. Initial thoughts on dressage: I'm sad because he jig jogged, but just gonna put it out of my mind now. All I want this weekend is a nice clear cross country round. So here we go, jump one, same as September. Downhill. This is our new one. I like this one. Right here. Oh, and I stepped in. I was trying to show you B. I'm not walking up there. I know I do the ditch palisade and then I go round to the toolbox and then this one. It's the same course as last time. This one's large. Really? Just at my hips. Hey guys, dressage results are in. I forgot to do my score prediction, but we got 65. But we're sitting in fifth, which is still pretty good, behind four professional riders: Sam Lyle, Andy Danes, Hazel Shannon, and Charlotte Lalak. They're all professionals, so I'm pretty happy with that.
It's been a while. Just picked up the ice, rode down the bike, and then I left the bike because I'm not skilled enough to ride and carry ice. So we've got about an hour into a cross country and we're running around like headless chooks, but we'll be right.
These cross country boots have served you well.
Yeah, I need new ones. Ruby,
you cut it short.
It's really short.
I look like a Lord Farquaad.
Do you like it?
Do
you like it or not?
You say that's good. Oh, you're so nice. Okay, guys. Ta-da! I've got a pink and green ribbon as well.
This is a really bad angle, but I'm really excited about my new base layer.
Your fave bike riding bitch is back.
We're just about to go cross country.
Oh my god, the base layer.
In the new fit, we're loving it. I'm going to cycle down and try and get as many videos as possible. And we're wishing good luck for Brianna. Double clear vibes.
God, he felt amazing. I'm over the moon. Sydney is just our happy place. He just loves it out on course. I was looking at his ears and they're like forward, not in a speaky way, but in a happy way. And we had some really nice moments out there, some really good distances, but then he would save my butt for the bad ones. That's all I cared about before our one star next week. I just wanted a positive, clear round and clear and under. So that means we are in top five. So I'll update you when everyone has finished cross country. But now I can finally sit down and take a breath. I can't believe how close together my dressage and cross country was. I feel like I did dressage, walked the course, and then did cross country. So it's been intense. All right, that after cross country glow, my makeup's all ruined.
You're beautiful.
I tried to put my hair in a bun, but it's too short now. Heidi, please don't kill me. I'll do half up, half down. What's over there?
Ruby's over here.
It was really good. We're super happy. We're also very hot and tired. And we'd like showers and naps.
Yeah.
But we have to tend to the rat first. Yeah. Sorry, not the rat. The
superstar.
The prince in shining armor.
These are the best.
Oh.
Why is it best eventing drink ever?
I went and washed him in the mud. I made my sandwiches.
Look at this mess. What a disaster.
We're about to make the move to the stables. Off you go. Find your home now, lost boy.
Wait, this can't really very comfortable. Off we go. Come on.
Bye,
Vinny. Okay,
everyone,
don't look at my hair. I'm not looking my best, but we just finished doing Finn's stable. Okay,
done. Yeah, good feet. He's got, hey. Order.
Good to go.
Ready.
He's such a good boy. Oh my goodness.
All right. It is just past five and we've just been slowly packing up because I'm going to move the float over to where Amy is in the south, parking over here. And then we watched the four-star show jumping. I should have taken some videos, but that was really cool. And Finny's just been hanging out. I like him to be in the stable for as little time as possible because he doesn't like it in there. And I think like the more attention I pay him, the better he goes for me. So yeah, I'll give him a massage and I'll tough rock his legs, put on his rug, let him have a roll. It's Finny's best friend, Jojo. Oh, these guys go on holiday together. They actually love each other.
They have the same halter too. Finn's got that halter.
Yeah, I didn't bring it this time.
And they have the same boat boots.
Oh. Get into it, Finny. Horses are going to go to bed now. We're doing our last graze and pick, but he hasn't been in the stable like at all for the entire day, so early night for everyone. He hasn't been in the stable for more than 5 minutes like all day, so I put him to bed much earlier than usual. I usually come back and do a night walk, but because we're so far away, I think this will do for today because I'm exhausted.
So I'd already put my hand in the bucket. So I was like, I'm going to try and tie up his tail without getting calf ruck all over it. And I somehow managed to tie my fucking hand in his tail. I'm not even joking. How did I do that? I was just trying not to get it dirty. Can you please try his tail?
Ruby's watching edits on her phone. And Bree's in there.
Turn around. Do a 360. Yeah.
I ain't gotta get naked for no tennis bracelet, but I need 20 bands for a fucking anklet. He gave me neck, now I got patek. These bitches only want that shit cause they her future.
Hi. Sleep.
What if I didn't shower?
I'd be so fucking disgusted. I'd never leave. You'd be sleeping outside.
I guess
hygiene is important, ladies.
No, just for one night. Maybe. I'm so tired.
I don't care. You smell feral.
You smell feral. I've got tough rock on my wrist.
I smell like pomegranate deodorant.
Smell. Take a whiff. Take a whiff.
You smell like rat deodorant.
You aren't using the Dove roll-on, I know.
Puff the salad.
The creature was stirring.
What? It's okay, I still I saved most of it. Shut up! I saved most of it. I thought I had forks, but they're tiny fucking spoons. Ruby and I are trying to eat our pasta.
Okay, it's diet fucking planning.
What? You don't like my cooking?
No, I love it.
I'm not really working. This is about all.
What
we
do you
can.
Mean?
So we just go like.
Good night, vlog. Good
morning, everybody. It is Sunday today. I'm not too sure if the other girls are awake, but I've been up for about an hour. Just waking myself up because we're so tired, so we needed a big sleep. It's about 7 o'clock and I'm just walking to the stables to go and say hi to the boys. I'm much dressed down for the occasion. I'm wearing my space shorts, my sneakers with no socks. This is my Glass Animals hoodie.
Morning, Finn. Hi.
Good morning, Leo. Hello.
The boys are having a little bit of a pic. I still look like came out of like early 2000 mother's fever dream, but enjoying some very lovely long grass outside the stables.
Good morning, cutie pie. I've got a present for you. Thank you to Ruby's mum for making pizza, which we are happily eating for breakfast.
Look, this is what my kids made me. Remember, I was telling you about it.
Oh my god!
I got a friendship bracelet. They're like, oh, we made it too little. And I said, oh, I'm going on a holiday with a friend. Oh, it can be for her.
I'm going to put it on my pin board. I'll treasure it forever. Thank you. Okay, so you can finally see my curls. Without them being completely flattened in my helmet.
I like it.
I think I like it really short. I'm happy. So thank you, Sandy. Anyone needs,
sure is the way to go.
Yeah. If anyone needs a hairdresser, go to Lynham Hair and ask for Sandy or Jamie. They do a great job. Look, guys, I'm actually wearing shoes today. We're just going to go clean the stable so it's done nice and early.
She's coming back in record time.
Okay, we did some off-roading and we parked there, ended up here, and we're going to walk to the water and watch the two star cross country.
I sprinted all the way to the show jumping in hopes to watch Catherine, but she already went and they put it down to 95, so I'll just walk it now.
Straight onto 9.
I've been to the stable like 4 times this morning. Time to finish it. last once again, tucked up Finny. And now we're gonna show jump. Massive shout out to Ella for getting me through this terrible warm-up. He was being quite naughty, which I feel obliged to tell you about. He was stopping at the crossrails at the start. That's not a new thing. He just kind of has a thing about crossrails sometimes. But anyway, just felt like a bit of a mess. And this round, I'm not very proud of. Jump one was fine. Got a bit deep to number two. And then just an unlucky rail there, I think. That was one of our better distances, actually. But he had it down, which was very sad because without that rail, we would have come third in the class. So frustrating, but that's what happens when you don't have it together. Like, I was sort of chasing him into the jumps as well, which didn't help. This double was quite nice. But yeah, most of our distances were a bit weird. This one was ill. So yeah, just not a great round. So it was a little bit disappointing to have dressage and show jumping not go great. But like I've said, all I cared about was a clear, bold, positive cross-country round. I forgot to tell you, we actually got 0.8 speeding fines as well from that round, but that was fine. Like practicing, you know, going one-star speed before our one-star in a week's time.
He's so chuffed with himself. Yeah.
Lunch. I am wearing your socks. Well, I've got socks in my pocket.
Do you? Let's swap socks. Swap shorts and sweat all weekend. So
what's another
pair of socks?
Okay.
Alrighty, we're pretty much all packed up. I'm really happy with our neat, organised packing. All Ruby stuff is in the back. In the back seat, and then we've got all our stuff in here and the float. So all we have to do is get us food from the fridge and then chuck in on, and then we'll go straight after Amy's cross country.
Oh, she's changing. Sorry.
That's a violation of my privacy. Don't show my
face.
No. No.
What? Thank you.
Finny's got a nice day yard in the shade here, so he can stay here until we are ready to go. Good boy. What do we reckon?
Stupidity.
The sunscreen keeps seeping into my eyeball and it really hurts. Anyways, we're just enjoying the sun. Actually, I'm in the shade. We've got a nice shady spot. Watching the 80 cross country. Waiting for Amy, and then I've got to collect my ribbon because even though we had a row, we only dropped to 7th, which is really good. And then we can hit the road. Amy and Leo went clear, and Finny's ready to go. I just hooked up the float, we're just sending videos to Amy, and then we'll go. Here's Finny in his purple ribbon. Show us your ribbon. We're all done, we're gonna get on the float now. So yeah, overall, very happy. I just wanted to clear cross country, and that's what we did. So,
stay up.
Yeah, we'll see you for the Canberra vlog. Thank you for watching. Say bye.
Bye.